Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. My name is Inderpreet Singh and I am a community activist here in Atlanta trying to discover and follow the Sikhi way of life. Currently, I am also the president of American Sikhi Educational and Empowerment Network and currently the director for Global Sikh Council in United States. So the World Council of Churches is an inter-churches world organization. So they held this convention to mark the 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak. And they invited around 40 Sikh as well as Christian leaders from across the world to commemorate this milestone. It was a very nice convention where Sikh leaders as well as Christian leaders came together and talked about the universal message of Guru Nanak, how his message of universal brotherhood, equality, and nurturing motherhood can actually bring about solutions to the current problems facing this world. So the event started with the youth, Sikh youth, sang a very melodious Shabad, Awal Allah Noor Paya Kudrat Ke Sab Bande. And after that, with the introductions for the various leaders that had come together, there were a couple of topics that the leaders talked about and discussed, primarily how Guru Nanak's message of universal brotherhood can bring about peace, how the Guru Nanak's message of equality can bring or uplift the woman in current world, as well as how Guru Nanak's message of nurturing motherhood, earth can help and bring about conservation and solve the current environmental problems. So most of the discussions were revolved around the Guru Nanak's teaching and the teachings in Guru Granth Sahib. Everybody agreed that Guru Nanak's message can really solve the current problems. You know, these days we know a lot of Sikh organizations are celebrating this event inside the Sikh community. But this was a different event because we do not just want to talk about Guru Nanak inside our Sikh organizations or Sikh community. So this event actually helped us talk to the world outside, how the Guru Nanak's message can bring about change in this world, you know. And that is important, I believe, because Sikhs today are a little bit shy sharing Guru Nanak. You know, we keep Guru Nanak with us only. We do not want to share Nanak, thinking that we do not want to convert anybody. But today I would say to all Sikhs that open your arms and share your Nanak. You know, until and unless we don't share Nanak's message across the world, we will not really be able to bring change in this world. So Guru Nanak challenged the current rituals and practices that did not bring any meaningful change or did not bring any meaningful advantage to the society. So he challenged all those practices. Maybe, you know, like cleanliness was one of the rituals that you know, the religious leaders would practice. You know, to do anything, you had to take a bath. To do anything, you know, you would have to wash your hands umpteen number of times. Those kind of practices, Guru Nanak said, does not bring any change, you know, any value. Any similar norms like, you know, giving water to, you know, sun or taking fasts or, you know, having a thread around you, Guru Nanak challenged what is the value. He always, he was open to reach out to people, you know. He traveled around like 40,000 kilometers, you know, and discussed his, you know, his ideas, you know. He wanted to talk, he wanted to discuss, you know, and he wanted to bring real change. It's very important to have these meetings, you know, because that's the only way we can talk about our Sikh ideology, we can tell the world. You know, Bernard Russell, one of the Nobel Prize winners, said, you know, the biggest crime that the Sikh community is doing is not telling this treasure, not sharing this treasure in Guru Granth Sahib with the outside world. So these meetings are really important for us to be able to tell the world what Guru Nanak's teachings are all about. But I would say one more thing, that now when we are trying to celebrate Guru Nanak's 550th birth anniversary, it would not be really a celebration unless we start following those teachings. You know, that is my message, that if you really want to actually celebrate Guru Nanak, you need to follow his message, you need to follow the universal brotherhood, you need to follow the equality that he preached. You know, you need to conserve and treat your mother earth as really important, and unless we don't follow these teachings, all these events are of no value. And that is what Guru Nanak's message is: you act, you know, not just preach. Right, so there were many community activists that came and talked. One of them was Dr. Harshinder Kaur, who came from India, Patiala, and she talked about women rights and other infanticides that's occurring, you know, and how we can eliminate some of those evils based on Guru Nanak's teaching and his inspirations. Another speaker was Dr. Iktidar Cheema, who came from England. And he is one of those persons I would emphasize, who actually was able to bring Guru Nanak's teachings and writings in United Nations document on interfaith. So this is a big achievement, that for the first time ever, a United Nations document has Guru Nanak's three teachings, and it's very important for the Sikh community as well as for the outside world. Another Sikh community leader, Ms. Tina Kaur, talked about the environmental issues and how Guru Nanak's message of treating earth nicely can help achieve us, conserve and solve a lot of these environmental issues. So the most important thing that came out of this convention was that everybody one agreed that we all need to propagate Guru Nanak's teaching outside the world, you know, so everybody can get inspired from his teaching and actually follow his path. The second thing that the Sikh community, the Global Sikh Council members who attended this, took upon themselves was to create some youth groups so that we can work on some of these issues, especially on environmental issues. Also create some conventions and talks how to uplift women and how to bring about power and build women rights in India. The biggest gift that the Sikh community can give to Guru Nanak is to first understand Guru Nanak's teaching themselves and then try to follow his path, and second, propagate and spread his message. That is the biggest gift I believe the Sikh community can do. You know, create literature, create media, create documentaries, create films that inspire and talk about Guru Nanak's message. Thank you so much. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.